Glad you could join us for another video from Far North Bushcraft and Survival. My name is Lonnie, and behind the camera is my wife, Connie. And this video is going to be about how to light a fire when everything's wet. Now, it's not raining much right now. It's just kind of misting a little bit, maybe. And, you know, when you don't want it to rain, the best way to get it to rain in many parts of the U.S. is to wash your car or your pickup. That'll almost guarantee a rain. And then your car or pickup gets all muddy. Well, I've discovered how to stop it from raining. And that is to try to do a bushcraft or survival video on what to do when it's raining. I've tried this about fifth time I've tried this. And I think just about every time it stopped raining. But we're going to go ahead and do it anyway. You just have to take my word for it. Everything out here is soaked. It was raining for like 30 hours straight. And then last night, off and on, it rained all night long. It was raining this morning too. So, okay. What we need, as you may be able to see in the camera view perhaps, we're surrounded by birch. So we could easily use birch bark to start a fire easily. But we're not going to do that because many places around the world, around the U.S., don't have that access to paper birch. So we're going to do it a different way that's more universal. Okay, what we want is a dead standing tree, fairly small diameter. We've got a perfect one here. But we don't want this one, and the reason why is because it's leaning quite a bit, and because of that, the rain is going to land on it, and it's going to run down, and it's going to, you know, it's going to stay longer on top here, and it's going to run down, it's going to hang on the bottom, and the longer the rain stays on it, the more it's going to soak in. So what we want is one, if we can find it, is one that's standing pretty well straight up. Straighter the better. Well, we've got a small one back here we're going to use.
Right here.
So we're going to cut this down, and we'll see a little bit later when we're ready to start setting up the fire. We've got our place selected here that we're going to build the fire. Now, it's imperative that you keep your fixings, your fire fixings dry. And it's not raining right now. You can see out on the lake there, it's pretty still. But well, let's just pretend that it is raining. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to make a real quick shelter to build the fire under. We'll leave our branches, our tree pieces, we'll leave them here up off of the ground so they're not going to get wet. For this, we're going to have to gather a bunch of alder branches. Okay, I'll show you what we're going to do with these, and then I'll go back and continue to gather. Now, what we're going to do is we're just going to lay them over this branch above us. Now, we're going to want to knock this, not loose any of the rain drips that are on this. And then we're going to make ourselves a roof over the top. turn this into a rain shelter to protect our fire makings. All right, we'll come back when we've got this a little more prepared. So we've got our shelter pretty thick here to where it's gonna stop all but just a few drips. And now what we're gonna do is we've got our wood here. We took off our rain jacket since we're underneath here and won't need it. And the wood does need it. We wanna keep this wood dry. So now we're gonna attempt to split this. Now with the, as you can see, this thing is full of knots. So it might give me some difficulty. But the challenge is try to find an area where there's the least amount of knots. Okay. Now, as you recall, this was dead standing. And there's total altogether probably 35 hours of rain here in the last 2 days. It didn't soak in hardly at all. So, we're good to go here. So we're going to continue splitting this up. And I'll come back when we've got that done. Now what I'm going to do is make a few feather sticks. Now, I'm by no means a professional at this, but I can put out ones that work. And that's all that matters here in this case. As you can tell, the mosquitoes are terrible here. Now this is spruce that I'm using. It doesn't have to be spruce. Poplar works fine. Aspen, cottonwood, willow. many different types of trees will work just the same way as this for starting a fire when everything's wet. Okay, I'll come back here in a little bit when I've got this ready. Okay, now what we're doing is we're just going to make a whole bunch of shavings. We've got a pile started already here. And we're just going to get a bunch of shavings. That's probably enough shavings. Now what we're going to do is I'm going to go over here to this tree behind me and I'm going to gather some pitch. Before I do that, I'm going to get ready to light the fire. And we're going to move this off to the side. Still, you got to keep it under the shelter. And notice I only split this in half. I saved half and I used the other half. What I'm going to do with this half is this is where I'm going to build the fire. This is where I'm going to start the fire. And that's to keep it up off of that damp ground. Okay. So, now, let's go get us some pitch. More mature trees, a lot of times you'll find old, dead, dry pitch, and this stuff is excellent for getting fires going, especially when everything's wet. Works wonders. Okay, we're ready to light this. But before we do that, I'm gonna get some spruce boughs from behind me. Now, here in Alaska, these go, you'll find a lot of dead, dry limbs underneath like this on these trees. And even though it might be a little bit damp from the rain, what we got going there is probably enough to get it started. All right, we're ready to light this up. Knocked everything all over. Knocked a bunch of our pitch off. Okay. Now, it pays to practice this stuff before you need it. Several years ago, we knew of a local moose hunter that had gotten stranded. He had gotten a moose down, and he'd called the neighbors for some help because he didn't know how to take care of a moose. And when they got there, he was very, very cold, close to hyperthermia. His lips were turning blue. Well, they got him all taken care of. They got him warmed up and whatnot. But later when I was talking to him, I said, well, why didn't you light a fire? And he said, well, I couldn't. It was raining and it was windy. Well, you know, that's where experience comes in. And that's why I'm doing this video, in hopes that I can help some other folks who might be in a similar situation. Like I said, we had plenty of birch bark around here. We could have lit this fire real fast, real easy. But birch bark isn't always available. So you need to go at it a little bit different way, perhaps. So there you have it. We can just keep adding on. There's enough of a fire there now. It's gonna dry out these branches that are on the trees, and we're good to go. So thanks for joining us, and we'll see you on the next video.